Political campaigns across the globe invest heavily in delivering targeted appeals to voters. One common tool for doing so is door-to-door canvassing. Previous research has shown that these short, in-person conversations with campaign staff and volunteers can have large effects on voter turnout. In other words, they influence voters' decisions on whether or not to vote. But to what extent do they also affect who they vote for? Can these brief encounters change voters' minds? This paper provides the first estimates of the effects of door-to-door canvassing on actual vote shares and leverages the results of a countrywide experiment conducted during the 2012 French presidential election. Up to that point, French political parties had placed relatively little emphasis on recruiting volunteers and coordinating large field campaigns. While door-to-door canvassing was once more common, it had gradually been replaced by less logistically demanding techniques, such as handing out flyers. During the 2012 campaign, however, the mainstream center-left party in France embraced a new strategy and canvassed heavily in support of its presidential candidate, François Hollande. Over the period from February to May 2012, an estimated 80,000 left-wing activists knocked on 5 million doors to encourage people to vote for Hollande. The author of this paper served as one of the three national directors of the field campaign, and this provided a unique opportunity to embed a large-scale randomized study within the campaign's operations. Let's start with some relevant background. Presidential elections in France have two rounds, where the two candidates with the highest vote shares in the first round proceed on to a runoff in the second. Voter turnout is typically high. In 2012, 79.5% of registered citizens voted in the first round of the presidential election, and 80.4% voted in the second. In terms of results, Hollande advanced out of the first round, along with the incumbent, Nicolas Sarkozy, and then subsequently won the second round with 51.6% of the vote and was elected president. So the question is, to what extent did door-to-door canvassing contribute to Hollande's winning vote shares? To answer this question, the author implemented the following randomized experiment as part of the field campaign. First, the entire country was split into territories, each comprising a set of municipalities sharing a common zip code. Then, within each territory, randomization was done at the precinct level, and only those precincts in the treatment group were assigned to be covered by the door-to-door campaign. Canvassers were instructed to provide basic information about the election, including the date and opening times of poll offices, and to encourage people not only to vote, but to vote for Hollande. These discussions typically lasted from 1 to 5 minutes. It is worth emphasizing that the sheer scale of this experiment sets it apart from previous research on this topic. Though the study's sample comprised only part of the broader field campaign, it covered 791 territories, accounting for over 5 million registered voters spanning all regions of the country, including both urban and rural areas. So what did the author find? First, and in contrast to other studies, door-to-door visits had no impact on voter turnout in either the first or second round of the election. In other words, canvassers did not influence voters' decisions over whether or not to vote. There was, however, a significant impact on the share of voters who voted for Hollande. Door-to-door visits increased Hollande's vote share by 3.24 percentage points in the first round and by 2.75 percentage points in the second round in precincts that were covered by canvassers because they were assigned to the treatment group. Scaling these results by the total number of doors knocked as part of the broader field campaign, the author estimates that canvassing accounted for approximately one-half of Hollande's lead in the first round of the election and one-fourth of his victory margin in the second. Moreover, these effects were not limited to the presidential election. The impact of the visits persisted into the parliamentary elections held 1 month later and, to a lesser extent, into the European elections held in 2014. What drives these results? Did canvassers persuade undecided voters who otherwise would have chosen another candidate? Or did they mobilize left-wing voters who otherwise would have stayed at home, while also demobilizing right-wing voters? The author argues that the most likely explanation is that canvassers changed swing voters' perceptions of both Hollande's party and the candidate himself in a positive direction. On this point, it is notable that this kind of large-scale field campaign was not common in France at this time, and thus most voters had never been visited by a political activist before. While it is unlikely that such a brief interaction could have changed voters' preferences over core political issues, canvassing served as a strong, positive signal that Hollande and his party were willing to engage with voters and to embrace modern and innovative techniques. In conclusion, this paper uses a countrywide randomized experiment to investigate the effects of door-to-door canvassing on voter choice. Of course, there are particular elements of the French electoral system that might lead to different results elsewhere. For example, partisan affiliations tend to be weaker in France relative to bipartisan, highly polarized contexts such as the US. Nonetheless, this paper provides evidence that door-to-door campaigns can actually affect electoral outcomes. As always, you can check out the full paper and its references to other related research. These include papers in both economics and political science on the effects of door-to-door canvassing, evaluations of other campaign techniques such as direct mail and robocalls, and finally, a broader literature on how persuasive communication more generally, whether through TV, the internet, or other media, can affect voters' preferences and behavior.